So, you're probably wondering what is this ratchet ass PC doing behind me with the stock cooler and you know, no backplate and you know, this, I don't know what casing is this. That's because this PC is obviously not mine. Come on, I'm a bangsawan. I have not one, but two RTX 2080 Ti. It belongs to our very special guest that I'm gonna introduce to you guys right after the local sequence and right after you subscribe. If you don't subscribe, you cannot see who the special guest is. Ha! I told you we have a special guest, right? Do you want to guess if it's a guy or a girl? Confirm you guess girl. You're so smart, boy. So smart. Come, have a seat. Please introduce yourself.
What's up, guys? I'm Lila Cookie. I'm a streamer with this really sad-looking PC that has so not sad. Been torn off. I mean, this tempered
it's
mask.
So sad that she doesn't even want to take off the sticker because she can't bear looking at the insides of this person. You know what people say, like, you know, beauty is from the inside. It's all just a lie. Unless you have RGB inside, then beauty is actually from the inside.
No makeup can cover that.
No. Do you know what RGB stands for?
No.
Real gay boys.
Oh, I didn't expect that.
So today we are going to check out her PC, do a little bit of maintenance because she hasn't cleaned it since 1969. So we are going to use the good old vacuum cleaner, a brush, and you know, and suck out all the dust. And also to check out the problems potentially to do with the airflow and stuff, because you said that it's running a bit hot, right? It's like a toaster oven. Nobody wants a toaster oven next to them when they're gaming. Other than that, we're going to check out what specs she has inside and try to upgrade that so that she can run things at a more than cinematic 25 frames per second. Let's get started. Okay, let's start by having you pull out your specs. Young people these days, they don't know the joy of having pen and paper.
Do you want to write it down for me, no. Uncle?
Okay, the door is that way.
You put the uncle in bangsawan.
So she has an i5-7400 and then a Gigabyte B250M Gaming 3. Not bad. Crucial 8 gigs. There's the PNY 128 gig SATA SSD. You have the GTX 1060 6GB Armor Series, I think. No backplate, Armor Series. And then the case is a Techwear Edge. PSU is some dodgy one.
Igo.
It's Igo, it's not Igo.
Yes, Igo.
Yeah, I saw Chinese words on the top and I was like, no. But I go is not bad sometimes, so we'll see. Other than that, that's
Windows
it.
10.
Yeah, Windows 10. Mm-hmm. Install original Windows. Don't buy 5,000 PC and then you use the pirated stuff. You tell your mother you use pirated Windows and you kiss her with that same mouth.
Shame on your cow.
Shame on your Windows. All right, so this is a low production video today. We don't have two cameras, we only have one camera. That is why we're using my phone, my trusty phone, and show you what's behind the scenes and the close-ups so you can actually see how filthy this thing is. Okay, let's see. Look at all this dust. You know, I bet a spider colony could just move right in and then build a metropolis right inside. Population 6 million. Look at that.
I have a farm of dust bunnies.
Okay, at least the top removal filter is clean. Did you at least take this out and shake it? And
nope.
Clean? Nope.
I'm just surprised that there's dust underneath the net.
Yeah, because this is probably an exhaust, probably set out as an exhaust. Now, let's look at the front, which is relatively out of focus. Oh, wait. Relatively clean. So it's relatively clean. Now let's just open up this side panel and see what's inside.
I'm so clumsy.
Okay, so we have the very the disgusting, very the out of focus stock cooler right here. Oh my goodness. How do you live next to this colony
like
of dust? So the, yeah, I'm right, it's the Armor Series. And doesn't have a backplate. Let's look at the fan underneath. Seems okay. The front fans look practically pristine. And that's probably because there's not enough airflow to actually do anything in terms of moving air through. Okay, now let's take a look at the airflow setup of the casing. As you can see, these three fans at the front are set up in exhaust mode. And the two fans on top are actually set up in intake mode. What's surprising for me is that there's no dust on top and all the dust is at the bottom. Usually it doesn't happen that way with intakes. And the back is also exhaust, blowing air out. So you have four fans in exhaust and then two fans in intake, therefore it's negative airflow. I think in a casing like this, you should go for positive airflow because, okay, not just in a casing like this, because you are, she is an amateur PC owner, so she won't clean her PC every 3 months. As you can see, she hasn't touched it since she got it.
Yes, a year ago.
Right, so we should set up in a more low maintenance manner, which means positive airflow. So we're gonna have to change the direction of all these fans around. So what we're gonna do is gonna give you a quick clean and we're gonna change the fans around. Then we're gonna introduce to you guys the parts that we are going to add to upgrade this PC. Now that we've gotten all cleaned up, Jesus. Okay, now that we've gotten this all cleaned up, let's start by flipping on the light so that people can see what the heck's going on inside. And we're going to turn the orientation of the fans at the front so that they blow in instead of blow out. And we're going to remove the Intel stock cooler and put on something a lot beefier because it will be cooler for the CPU and then it can be cool like a cucumber.
Whoa! Holy.
Okay, now that we've removed the stock cooler and flipped the fans around, we're going to clean up the residual thermal paste on there with some isopropyl alcohol or alcohol swab. And then we are going to install this bad boy. Alcohol swab with the... Give it a try. Now that we've placed the CPU cooler, it's time that we remove the sad, lonely, and naked little RAM module at the back of the PC and replace them with two brand new sticks of Kingston HyperX DDR4 RAM rated at 2666 MHz at CL16. So it's not the fastest and the tightest memory out there, but this is one of the most affordable memory modules outside that you can buy.
Black and red.
Yeah, the black, the red ones, the two red ones. Make sure the orientation is right now.
The two sticks
of RAM are inserted. And now we need to install the final step, which is the SSD, the SSD. And today, we are adding another SSD that's very the cheap, which is the Patriot Burst SATA 2.5-inch SSD SSD. And this is going to be where she stores all her games, her Premiere Pro, her After the Effects, and all the different things. So we're finally done. If you guys are wondering just why I was so lethargic for the beginning half of this video, it's because I'm sensitive and I'm allergic to shitty PCs. And now that we've revamped this, you know, that it looks more presentable. You see my energy level went out the roof. Okay, so today, let's see what we've done to this PC, right?
So what have you done to bangsawanified my PC?
I pimped her PC as best I could with the budget that she allowed, which was not much, okay? We pimped the whole thing for under 1,000 ringgit, actually slightly less, right? So let's talk about the airflow of the case that we changed out first. We flipped up the three fans that were facing outwards in exhaust mode, and now they are in intake mode, so that we have more intakes versus outtakes, sorry. Exhaust versus exhaust. In this case, it will give us a positive airflow, which means there'll be more air going in than going out, which means it will cause all these little holes that used to suck dust inside due to negative airflow to now blow dust out. Actually, not blow dust out, like just blow out so that the dust from outside cannot come in. You know, like a valve. Get it? Number two, I suspect that the airflow wasn't the only reason that was causing her case to be very hot. You say it was very hot, right?
Like yes,
an oven,
was.
Right?
It was like a heater for my feet.
Okay, I suspect it's two reasons. Number one is it could be the stock cooler because it's not dissipating the heat from the CPU fast enough, especially when she's gaming and the utilization of the CPU is quite high. So I changed it to a new MSI Core Frozer L, which stands for large. It's so huge, it barely fits, okay? So why I picked this cooler? Very simple, because firstly, it looks cool. Number two, it has some red to match her red, see? Design.
It looks like a red fridge.
So it is beefier in terms of heatsink. Do you know why we have a bigger heatsink? So it'll provide more surface area for the heat to dissipate when you blow on it, you know. We're blowing on it with many fans. The third reason I thought could be the problem with your heat problem lah.
My heat problem.
Is the GPU. This is a lower end GPU model that has a more basic heat dissipation setup right here. The block doesn't cover all the other components inside that is creating a lot of heat, like VRM stuff like that. It's probably just covering the GPU, which means that there's no way of heat getting away from all those other heat creating components. So therefore, it's the issue. The only thing we can do about that is we make the airflow a lot better so that we get more clean air passing through and getting out of the case. So when it comes to the performance part, she said that she could barely stream PUBG. No, she couldn't even stream PUBG. Because it was running at less than a cinematic 25 frames per second. Which means when she tried to aim at somebody, they are already there.
Kristen,
if she fire a sniper rifle from here, and as she walk towards the front, she might hit herself. That's how laggy the performance was. So, for now, we have upgraded her tiny, her RAM is not tiny. Her RAM is standard size, okay, standard size. It doesn't come with a heat spreader, it's not dodgy or anything, it's just that it's a single stick that we couldn't match. So, we bought two sticks of HyperX 8GB rated at 2666MHz. You know why? Because cheap! Buying. So we have two sticks of this and it should give her a little bit more leeway when it comes to streaming, because games like PUBG, when you even play on it, it will take up about 8 gigs of RAM, maybe sometimes a little bit more. And that was why it couldn't move. Now you have two. So you can use this, but then you still got this. Okay, that's not how RAM works, but you know, basically. So in terms of storage, we bought another SSD for her because she was only running a 128GB of SSD, right? So when you bought the PC, the guy didn't even ask you to buy a HDD, right?
No, I didn't have enough funds to do it.
Oh wow, wow. Guys, if you guys realize this, right, if you buy a PC, do remember that you need more than just your OS, because you need to put your files and stuff like that. 128 gigs with your OS, some games, that's it. You can't do much. So we got this 240 gigs of Patriot Burst. It's the cheapest SSD we could find in the store, and we stuck it into there. So right now, she can install her Photoshop, InDesign, and all the stuff like Premiere Pro, After Effects, because she's in the Mass Comm program. So she's gonna do like all those kind of stuff. Now she can install it in here. That's all, folks. If you thought this video is awesome, if you thought her face was awesome, if you thought her hair is awesome, if you thought the hair color is actually awesome, please give us a like and subscribe. Remember to follow her at
Lila Cookie
on
Facebook.
Okay, yeah, where she streams games and all sorts of other kind of nonsense. And then also she will post her, you know,
my side of the story.
Her side of the story. And we will see you
you
in the next one.